Oh, look at that.
Talking about space was fun.
I like talking about space. Fantastic.
Hi, everyone. I am Astro Kirsten Banks. I'm an astrophysicist and science communicator. And today, this will be the inaugural APOD of the day. Let me tell you about what an APOD actually is. So APOD stands for Astronomy Picture of the Day. And it really is what it is. It's just the astronomy picture of the day. I have written a piece of code with the help of beautiful Stack Exchange to randomly generate a date from the APOD archive list so we can get a random date, get a random APOD, and we'll just enjoy space together by looking at APODs. So when I type in Python APOD date generator.py, it'll generate a date. And our first date is the 29th of June. Okay, so we're going to 2021 June 29. Oh, we're going to get Orion Nebula, the Hubble view. The Orion Nebula is like my favorite object in the entire world. Hello. Beautiful. Absolutely beautiful. One of Hubble's original photos of the Orion Nebula is actually what got me into space in the first place. Like, I always wanted to be something to do with science in the sky. I actually wanted to be a meteorologist first. But my science teacher took my entire year group on an excursion to the huge IMAX theater in Sydney. We watched the Hubble documentary, and it was a photo of this object taken by Hubble that just blew my mind. I was like, whoa, space is really cool. I need to study space. And that's why I'm an astrophysicist now. But let me tell you a little bit about the Orion Nebula. You can actually see it with your eyes. If you look towards the belt of Orion, the classic three stars, and you see the dagger, Orion's dagger, the smudge in Orion's dagger is actually the Orion Nebula. So you can see it with your naked eye. I think it's about 1,300 light years away, 1,500 light years away. So a great thing with APOD is that they give you a little blurb at the bottom as well. So 1,500 light years away. It is massive as well. If I remember correctly, it's like 25 light years across. So if you were to shine a laser from one side of the Orion Nebula going all the way to the other side, it would take 24 years to travel across. It is huge. So that is one. We've seen one APOD. Let's go to another. And you know, we can just go press up and go again. And now our next one is the 29th of February, 2020. The 29th again. Julius Caesar and leap days. Let's see what we get. Oh, okay. What is this? I don't know what this is. So luckily, we had the explanations. Let's see. In 46 BC, Julius Caesar reformed the calendar system, and the Julian calendar included one leap day for every 4 years to account for the fact that the Earth year is slightly more than 365 days long. That makes sense. I thought this day, the leap day of the leap year. That's kind of cool. All right, let's do another one. I wonder, will we get another 29th? I don't know. 14th of August, 2022, just last year. 4,000 exoplanets. I'm going to guess that this will be the date that we surpassed 4,000 exoplanets, and that's why it's there. And what is it? Oh, it's a video. Ooh, let's watch the video. It's from an, oh, you know what this is? Yes, it is showing us what planets were found, exoplanets that were found over the years from the first detection in 1992. The first detection were two exoplanets, actually, orbiting around a pulsar. And you see, as we continue on, we're to the year 2001 now. There's a few more being found. But as we get further and further, it just goes up so quickly. We've found new ways to find exoplanets. You can find them by planets, they're moving in front of their star. So they like dip the light of the star that they're orbiting around from our perspective. Sometimes they can make their star wobble because of gravity as they orbit around their star. They make their star wobble side to side. That's called the radial velocity detection because it's making the radial velocity go wobbly. There's direct detection. That's a bit harder to do because it's hard to find exoplanets. But look, even 2019, oh, 4,000. 2019, we surpassed 4,000 exoplanets. Nowadays, we're well past 5,000 exoplanets just in our own galaxy. It's absolutely insane how many exoplanets we've found so far since that first detection in 1992. Absolutely insane. Let's go do another one. 16th of April, 2022. Let's find it. Orion Pines. I'm going to take a guess that this will be a picture of the Orion constellation with pine trees in the photo. It is indeed that. There's a pine tree. There's Orion. This actually is really good. Look, here is the three stars of the belts of Orion that I mentioned earlier. And here is his dagger. And see the smudge. It's very easy to see in this particular photo. This is a fantastic photo capturing the molecular clouds surrounding the Orion part of the sky. It's actually a part of a massive complex of molecular clouds. And molecular clouds are where stars are formed. So this is a really awesome part of the sky to capture in terms of astrophotography. So a fantastic photo here by Juan Carlos Casado. So, so cool. But yes, this smudge in the little dagger of Orion is the Orion Nebula from before. And there's some other cool ones you can see in here. If you look closely here, you've got the Horsehead Nebula. And next to that, this little fire-looking thing, it's called the Fire Nebula. But all three of these and the rest of this around this Orion part of the sky is part of the Orion molecular cloud complex. So a huge amount of gas and dust in space, all in the same sort of area, making stars. Oh, that's awesome. All right, let's do another one. This is really fun. What are we gonna get? The 5th of February, 2023, just this year. Enceladus by Saturnshine. Ooh. So Enceladus is a moon that orbits around Saturn. Curious to see what this looks like. This is going to be a space probe photo. Oh, look at that. Look at that. So what we're seeing here is Enceladus. One of Saturn's moons. It's a very icy moon. There's likely to be water, liquid water beneath this icy surface. Pretty much confirmed that there is, because if you look at the very bottom, you can see there's like stuff spurting out the bottom of Enceladus here. Those are like water geysers spewing out water through like cracks in the icy surface. On the right-hand side, that's sunlight. And on the left-hand side, that would be Saturnshine that they're talking about in the title there. So light from Saturn is so bright that it lights up that dark side, the side that's in the opposite side of the sun for Enceladus there. It's similar to Earth's shine. So when the moon is like a really tiny crescent shape, you can sometimes see the rest of the face of the moon kind of lightly lit up, just slightly. That is Earth shine. So it's the brightness from the sun bouncing off the Earth, bouncing off the moon. So it's the brightness of the Earth from the sun shining on it, making the moon just a little glow, beautiful little Earth glow. So that's what we're seeing here. That is really cool. What date are we looking at next? The 6th of April, 2019, ISS from Wallasey. Am I saying that right? I feel like I'm going to get, it's definitely not in Australia, this place, so my pronunciation might be bad. Oh, that's cool. Looks like it is a photo taken by Richard Addis from Wallasey. Where is this? Oh, in England. It's in England. I've never been to England, but I hope to go to England one day soon. This is really cool. Taking photos of the ISS. There are some really cool photos taken of the ISS passing in front of things like the moon, passing in front of the sun as well. So there are some really cool photos you can get of the ISS. I think it's the size of a football field, even though it's 400 kilometers above the surface of the Earth. It's still big and you can capture it on your phones. Well, maybe not on your phone, but you can capture it with cameras. But you can even see it fly by sometimes. You can check out ways to find the ISS. Let's do another one. Let's go December 16, 2017. A wintry shower. It's going to be a meteor shower. I would guess the Geminids, but December 15 in 2017 was the Geminids. So, oh, and it looks very cool. It was indeed a Geminids meteor shower photo. Look at that. Such a bright meteor. Some of them are a bit fainter, but like the Geminids are just so, so good. They can have lots of different colors. It's the king of meteor showers, so definitely my favorite. And this year, the Geminids meteor shower coincides with the new moon, or the phase of a new moon, which is really good because there won't be a big bright rock in the sky and washing out a lot of the fainter meteors. So, with no moon in the sky in December this year for the Geminids, it's going to be fantastic, as long as clouds don't come along. I swear, if clouds come along, I'm going to be really upset. Let's go. Let's do one more. Let it be a good one. 2016, August 19th. Oh, it's another meteor. So Perseid's another meteor shower at Sunset Crater. Interesting. Well, that's pretty. Oh, there's a few extra ones. That's pretty cool. But you know what? I'm not convinced. I want to do another one. I would want to get a really, really good one. I could be doing this all day if I don't get a good one. All right. Another February 20, 2020. Trifecta at twilight. Ooh, it sounds very cool. I'm going to guess it's planets in the night sky. Well, in the twilight sky. Oh, no. This is what I was talking about before. So we got the moon, big thing on the left-hand side there. And those dots going across, that's the International Space Station. And the orange dot to the right, it's orange. It's kind of circular. I'm going to say it's Mars. Is it Mars? It is Mars. The trifecta. Moon, ISS, Mars. That's really cool. That was the inaugural astronomy picture of the day, where we go through random images from the APOD archive and talk about how cool space is. If you like this video, give it a like, comment, share it, and we'll do more of these because talking about space is fun. I like talking about space. I'm Astro Kirsten. See you next time. Yeah. That'll do, right? People all like that, right?